2010 and an even better 2011. Yeah, we've got Justin Bieber on the show. We haven't. We've got Miles Kane on the show. Yeah. Sure, he's had a massive solo album, blah, blah, blah. Yeah, he's worked with Noel Gallagher and Griff Rhys. Fine. I just want a guest with iconic hair. That's all I want. And now I finally found it in the form of Miles Kane. When you go running, do you wear a suit?
Nike have actually made me a suit.
No, yeah. They haven't. A shell suit. So it's a normal suit, but in shell suit material.
No, unfortunately.
And then loafers
not.
With trainer bottoms, like Mick Jagger.
Yeah. Oh, that day's going to come. Isn't
it is. Jesus. It's soon. And then Scream's done a remix of the song.
Just did it, you know, and...
Are you happy with the result?
Yeah, I mean, it's...
Do you like to hear it when you're out dancing in Liverpool? Let it out.
Yeah. Euphoric. I haven't been in the club, but while it's
you
been on,
you don't frequent
but,
clubs.
You know, if it was... if I was in a club and it came on, I'd enjoy it, you know. You did a great job.
Where did the inspiration for the riff come from this song? So I've heard a story.
Well, this song was sort of made up of that riff and the let it out, and the chorus were all from three other tunes, three other demos, but the rest of the songs weren't very good, so we put it all together and wrote some words for the verse.
Made a hit.
And made a perfect pop tune. Inside of me, I'll draw it on.
I looked at it, your video on YouTube, and underneath it somebody said, as soon as that riff kicks in, I get an eargasm. Isn't that horrible?
That's
amazing.
Like it. Yeah.
The eargasm.
Eargasm.
Not interested. Talk to me about your album and how it differs from these singles. Is it, are there any surprises or any collaborations we've got to look forward to?
I think, yeah, from what's been, I think probably Come Closer is probably a good sort of blueprint for it all.
Mm-hmm.
And then, you know, Rearrange is just a great sort of rock and roll pop tune, and then you've got another pop song called Quicksand on there, which is real sort of pop and a bit sort of tongue-in-cheek as well. You know, it's got a batter in it.
Oh, yeah.
And, you know, I was sort of a bit... didn't know whether to do a batter because...
He means bat-bat-batter-bat-bat-bat.
And, But Griff Rhys sort of encouraged me to do it. So come closer.
How was your BDI tour?
Amazing.
Yeah. Which was the best?
Amazing.
But which was the best place to play? Because I came to see you in London. That was really good.
That was really good. I suppose we finished the tour in the Royal Albert Hall,
mm-hmm.
for the Teenage Cancer Trust gig.
Yeah.
And, you know, that was just a great night, and got my mum came down, my auntie, and, you know, it was a nice
moment.
Did
you introduce them to Liam Gallagher?
No, they didn't. No.
Swapped football teams, your allegiance to football teams when you were younger.
Yeah.
Why did you do that?
Just because, well, my uncle brought me up when my mum had been work, and he's a big Man United fan.
Yeah.
And
then,
you know, I'd start going to Anfield with my mates, and I had to tell my uncle that I can't do this anymore. Do you know what I mean?
You had to break up with Manchester.
Now. Yeah, I can't do it.
It's just not happening. Which lyric annoys you most in the world?
Oh, Jesus.
Too many?
Yeah.
Let me think of one. It's hard to think of one, isn't it?
I mean, I don't want to rip into anyone, but
no.
Scouting for Girls.
Say no more. So I wish I was James Bond, just for the day, kissing all the girls, blow the bad guys. eyes away. Can you describe to me the woman you're going to marry?
God knows when that'll happen. You know what I mean?
That's it.
Well, it's just been beautiful.
Anything else you want to say? When's your album out?
The 9th of May.
Cool.
Yeah.